Hi, I'm Billy Flynn, and today I am interviewing my on-screen best friend.
Oh, you.
Zach Tinker.
Hi.
The new Sonny, if you will. Okay. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Are you sure?
Bring it on.
How did you come to play Sonny? What was your audition process like?
Well, since the world is in utter turmoil, and has been for the last 2 years, everything is via internet. I had a Zoom audition, and then a Zoom call, or at a self-tape, and then a Zoom callback.
Who are you looking at? Why are you looking?
But I'll look back at the camera when I answer them.
I'm asking you the question.
I auditioned for it. It was not too bad of a process.
I'm asking you the question. Okay, now go.
It was an audition.
Tell us about playing Sonny on the Peacock series Beyond Salem and A Very Salem Christmas.
Ah. They were fun. They were kind of a branch out. Now that I can say I'm on the mothership show, it's a very different experience. So every time you get to do one of those spin-off things, I feel like I have to split the difference between you.
Yeah, not really though. It kind of just me.
Okay. it was fun. It was fun, Billy. It was fun.
What intrigues you about Sonny?
I think Sonny is very multifaceted. I think he's a very emotional guy. I think he always tries to do the right thing. I think he's prone to jealousy. But I think he's a good dude. And I like playing characters who are good dudes. I also like playing characters who are not good dudes. But it's really fun to like embody someone who you're like, oh wow, I feel like a decent human being. I should be talking to you. I feel like a decent human being playing this person. I'm not saying I'm not a decent human being.
You just like to play
one on TV.
Very good answer, Zach.
Thank you.
How does it feel being in a show airing on your grandfather's former network, NBC?
Wow.
Oh, hold on a second. So your grandfather used to run NBC?
He did. Grant Tinker.
So when the first question, when I asked, how did you come to play Sonny? What was your audition process like?
They did not give me the job, no. They did not.
Now we know.
I don't know why they didn't give you the job.
Okay. So.
But it's cool. It's very cool. A lot of people in my family are in production, and I was the only one who was like, "What am you trying to be in front of the camera?" But hey, it seems to be kind of working out. I'm here doing this. That's pretty dang cool. And yeah, it's on my grandfather, the channel that he ran. So all comes full circle, huh?
How long was he the head of NBC?
Quite a while.
Is he the one that came up with bong bong bong?
I don't think he personally came up with that, no.
Bong, bong, bong. He didn't do that?
No, I don't think he was in his room with the xylophone trying to come up with a bit.
Can you hum the theme of NBC?
He just did it for me.
But you have to do it.
Mm-hmm. Luckily, I'm not telling
you. Wasn't even a question.
Oh.
Chandler Massey, our good friend. Chandler Massey, the wonderful Will Horton. Mm-hmm. What advice, if any, did he give you before stepping into the role of Sonny?
He sort of filled me in on the background, you know, our relationship, how we met, kind of what we've been through. But then, more than anything, it was just, I think, our natural chemistry, just as, like, friends is really... I mean, the three of us, I feel like, got along very well. And Mr. Greg Rickard kind of got thrown in to that gumbo together, you know, everyone just kind of clicked together.
Yeah, I thought me and Chandler and Greg got along really well.
I knew he was going to do that. And, I knew he was going to leave my name out intentionally.
What are you looking forward to? Here's one that you could answer.
I've answered all of these. What are you talking about?
What are you looking forward to?
In life, in general?
I don't know. That's the question. What are you looking forward to? Yeah, sure, in life, man. What do you want to accomplish? Do you want to run NBC someday?
Having a family one day should be nice.
Oh boy, do you got work to do.
Okay. What do you mean?
Let's just go. Anything? How about a Sonny? Anything?
Well, I don't know. We get the scripts, so I don't...
5-year plan. Where is Sonny? It's not that hard.
It's so 5 year?
5 year plan.
That's a lot of time.
Ask me.
What's 5 year plan?
For Chad?
Yeah.
5 year plan for Chad is he owns the Demerara Mansion. Finally. EJ moves to Paris. Jake moves to Paris. Moves to Paris. Harold finally shows himself.
And then moves to Paris.
And then moves to Paris. Chad installs new locks on his doors.
What? Why would you need more locks?
So people stop walking into my home.
We should probably get on to the next question. All right. I love thinking it.
What messages? I don't even need that. I have it memorized. What messages do you have for the fans?
Hey, fans.
You're doing good.
As you can tell, we're having a lot of fun here. We think you'll like the stuff that's coming up. I think you'll like it. Chad, on the other hand.
Yeah, no, that's what I was saying. I think this interview, the show you're going to love, this interview, at best.
Well, I had a great time, personally. Make sure to tune in to the Days YouTube channel.
Click the little like button down below, and please subscribe to the Days YouTube channel, where you're gonna see. You won't see him anymore, I promise. But me.
Wait, why?
Maybe.
Why won't you see him?
Maybe. Cut. Can't use any of that. Are you snorting?
Yeah, it happens.
Are you a snorter?
Sometimes.
Ugh, this is just off the rails.